What is a testosterone booster? How does it differ from anabolic steroids?
One, testosterone boosters are typically endogenous, meaning what they're doing is they're increasing our natural levels of testosterone, either by increasing free testosterone, which we talked about, and limiting SHBG binding, or by inhibiting the aromatase or 5-alpha reductase enzymes, and thereby decreasing the amount of conversion we have to DHT and estrogen, increasing our own natural levels of testosterone. Anabolic steroids are exogenous, so they are created in a lab to mimic testosterone or testosterone-like supplements. They're either rubbed on as a cream, some are taken as pills, most are injected, and that is a synthetic mimicker of testosterone levels that we're taking in. The response to the body is very different in that typically a testosterone booster is increasing testosterone levels that typically tend to stay within normal range. Still having an increased testosterone will lead to some increased benefit, but exogenous testosterone, anabolic steroids, typically increase testosterone levels exponentially, well beyond superphysiological levels, is which ultimately leads to some of the negative side effects.
So one could definitely conclude that taking a good testosterone booster that increases total testosterone and at the same time also increases free testosterone or reduces binding would definitely deliver results, but nowhere close to what one could expect from the use of anabolic steroids. And then obviously there are side effects to that. But having come to results, obviously we can't be hypocritical in saying that a person who's on anabolic steroids and a person who's on a testosterone booster will get the same results.
Yeah, no, that's a great question and great comment. You can't compare the effects of an anabolic steroid to that of a testosterone booster. It would be saying the same as testosterone replacement therapy for someone who is no longer producing testosterone because of age or other factors. Anabolic steroids have an exponential increase, which means their results tend to be much more exacerbated. However, the negative side effects are also exacerbated. Whereas what we see typically with natural testosterone boosters, that they don't, at least in the ones that I have studied, specifically Andropique, there were no negative side effects on blood hormone variables, clinical chemistry panels, lipid panels, red blood cell counts, those kind of things. So there didn't appear to be any negative side effects from those. Where with the anabolic steroids and their exponential increase in testosterone, that leads to the negative side effects that we see, that we read about, that we hear about happen with people who use anabolic steroids.